गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विथ द न्यू टॉपिक कॉन्वोल्यूशन। वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस टॉपिक और दिस ऑपरेटर सिंस लॉन्ग। ओके, when we talked about the systems, LTI systems, we said that suppose there is a system whose impulse response is given by HN and to this system we give a signal x of n, then we get output yn equals to xn convolution of h of n. Okay, now this we have already discussed. Anyone who is having any problem with this one, who does not have any understanding of this one? No? Okay, then let's move forward. So what does this physically mean? Okay, what is convolution? So suppose we are having two signal components x of n is equal to say 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, and another component is h of n, which is given by 1, 2, 1. Okay, now if I ask you to find out yn, where yn is given by x of n convolution of h of n, right? Now previously I have discussed with you that if there is no marker within the signal component, that means our origin is the first component of whatever the signal it is, right? So let's take up this one first and then later on we will go on to the other domains. So first I will start with the simplest method, which is the sliding tape method. Okay, so I will use that to make you understand what is the mechanics going behind convolution. Okay, so mechanics is, first you have to write down your signal xn in the normal order, and you have to change the h of n. Okay, another important thing is that if I ask you to find out x of n convolution of h of n, you can also find out h of n convolution of x of n, and both will be equal. Okay, so x of n convolution of h of n is equal to h of n convolution of x of n. Okay, So both are same. For the sake of simplicity, or for our example, we will take x of n as it is, and we will do the manipulation with the h of n. That means we will go for the computation of x of n convolution of h of n. Now, when we try to perform this kind of operation, we have to find out h of minus n. Okay, now what is h of minus n? H of minus n would be, it will be flipping, right? 1, 2, 1. Now the origin would be this one. So across the origin, if we consider this arrow as the pivot, so across this pivot, we have to flip the signal. Now once you have got h of minus n, then the main play starts. Okay. In the step one, what happened today? First, we have to find out y0. So, in y0, what we have to do, first, I have to write down the signal components 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have to match the origins and place the signal h of minus n accordingly. So this is the origin of the xn. So origin of the h of minus n is this one, right? Now my y0 would be 1 multiplied by 1. Okay, because the previous terms, if you see, there is no overlapping. No overlapping means these components are 0. Similarly, after 1 there is nothing. That means these components are also 0. So what you have to do? 1 multiplied by 1 is 1. So our y0 is 1. Okay? Now we have to find y of 1. So what is y of 1? Again, I will be writing down 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I am not giving the marking because I had made my point to you. Okay. So I will shift the HN signal. I will shift the HN signal one step to the right. So 1, 2, 1. Okay, so my y1 would be 2 plus 2, 2 multiplied by 1 and 1 multiplied by 2 is equal to 4. Okay, so my y2 would be 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 1, 2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 2 प्लस 1 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 1, 6. माई Y3 वुड बी 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 1, 4 प्लस 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 2, 6 प्लस 2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 1, 2, 12. देन माई Y4 वुड बी 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 2, 8 प्लस 3 मल्टीप्लाइड 1 बाई 1, 3. इट इज 11, राइट. देन Y5 वुड बी 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 1, 4. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन से यस.
सर Y2 विल बी 3 प्लस 4 प्लस 1.
Y1 इज 2, थ्री प्लस फोर, हाँ फोर, सॉरी. So this would be 8. Okay. So 3 multiplied by 1, 3, 2 multiplied by 2, 4, plus 1 multiplied by 1. Okay, 1. So our yn is equal to, we'll start with 0, 1, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Okay, and which is the origin? If there is nothing, we have already discussed that the first point is the origin. Now let us check what is the length of this signal. The length of this signal is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now this length of the signal can be calculated from the length of the given signals. Okay, so in this case the given signals are Xn and Hn. So what is the length of signal of Xn? So I can write it down as Xn. XL is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and HL equals to 1, 2, 3. So length of L, okay, I will just change this nomenclature of the length because later on we have to do another numerical where we may get confused. So I will give it as L of X, L of H and L of Y. Okay, so here L of Y, from our practical purpose, we have seen it is 6. So how do we get this? So we get by adding L of X plus L of H minus 1, which is equal to 6. So we can see practically we have seen that Y of N is having a length of 6, and by calculating also we have got that the length of the signal is 6. So in this way, we can verify our result. Okay. Now, in the next, so this is a sliding tape method. Noun. Let us take another example. Okay. In this example, say our xn is given by one, two, three, four, and h of n, it is also given by 1, 2, 1 and we have an origin at the second index at n equals to 1 and here we keep it as it is. So h of minus n is again we will be having 1, 2, 1. Okay. Now we have to match this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1, 2, 1. So now our y0 would be 2 plus 2 equals to 4. Y1 would be 3 plus 4 plus 1. Y2 would be 4 plus 6, 4 plus 6 plus 2. Y3 would be 8 plus 3, 11. And Y4 would be 4. Now you would say, sir, we are only having 5 components. What happened to the 6th component? 6th component, right? We have to remember that we have moved the h of minus n towards time tending to infinity. Okay. But we have to move the signal towards time tending to minus infinity too. That means we have to move this signal towards the left also. So in doing so, we have to, when we move the signal on the left hand side, then so initially we were having y0, right? Now if we move the signal to the left hand side, we'll be having y of minus 1. Okay, so when we move the signal to the right, we will be having the signal y1, y2, y3, y4 like this one. And if we move the signal to the left, we'll be having minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 likewise. So y of minus 1 would be, see, this will move on the left. So 1 multiplied by 1 and this will be multiplied with 0. This will be multiplied with 0. So we will be left with 1. So our signal yn It would be given by, again, 1, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Now here, where is our origin? Our origin is at 4. Right? Now, it is important to note that when we go towards other numericals, we will be given just this origin points and we have to calculate through some numerical points. We have to do some calculation and find out these values. Now, in those cases, where do we place our origin? Okay, because we will not be over here, we are calculating y0, y1, y2, y3, y4. But in the later cases, we will not be able to get the thing. So how to find out the origin of an output signal or of an or the output of a processing where a convolution has been carried out? So if you see, we have to calculate the number of numericals or number of points which are given after origin. Now if you see, in x of n, we are having the number of points after origin. So if I say it nx, it is 1 and 2. Similarly, if I calculate of n of h, it is also 2. So if we add up this, nx plus nh, it comes out to be 4. So in the output signal, if you see, if I move 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, after leaving 4 points, on the 5th point, I will be adding the origin. Okay? On the 5th point, I will be adding the origin. Okay? If you look in the first case also, our nx was 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So our origin is 1. Hence, we have already told that if the origin is is the first element of any given signal, then we may not put the pivot over there. Okay, so it means that our 1 is the, or the first element is our origin. Okay, so this is how you can find out the origin of a convolution sum. Okay, any doubt till now? Do you guys have any doubt till now?
No, sir.
Especially the MTech students, they requested this lecture.
No, sir.
Okay. This is called, this method is basically a linear convolution. What we are doing? We are linearly varying these values from left to right or to the left. So basically we come from minus infinity to infinity. Okay. So we perform the multiplication from minus infinity to plus infinity. So this sliding tape method provides us an indication of the mechanics. Okay. So I wanted to show you what actually is being done in the convolution process. Okay. Now next is tabulation method. The next is tabulation method. Our Xn was 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yeah. And Hn was 2. So we will be writing Xn on the top, 1, 2, 3, 4, and Hn on the y axis. So it is 1, 2, 1. So 1 multiplied by 1, 1. So 1 multiplied by 1. So this point, if you see, we are having these two elements. Okay. So over here, we will be having 1. Right. Similarly, 2 multiplied by 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this is 2. 4, 6, 8. Then this is again 1, 2, 3, 4. Now once you have done this thing, you have to draw these diagonal lines. Okay. Now your yn would be given by 1, comma 4, comma 4 plus 3, 7 plus 1, 8, comma 10, 12, comma 8 plus 3, 11, comma 4, right? Any problem till now? No? Okay.
No, sir. No.
So if you match the results, 1, 4, 8, 1, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Here we are having 1, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Now we have to find out the origin. Origin is, we have already talked, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after 5, we will be having the origin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after 5, this 1 is the origin. So we do not have to place any pivot. So in the tabulation method, you do not have the leverage to automatically have the origin, which we were having when we were applying or we were computing the convolution using the sliding tape method, because y0 is always the origin. Okay. But over here we do not have this leverage in the tabulation method, and hence this is you have to remember the stuff that where to place the origin. Okay. So this is basically also a linear convolution. Okay, I will draw this thing. So this is a linear convolution. Okay. Now we will do circular convolution. In circular convolution, we have to remember that both the signals, in this case xn and hn, should have same length. If we do not have the same length, then we have to zero pad the length which is having a shorter length. Okay, so in this case our hn is 1 2 1, so it is having only three components, so we have to zero pad the signal and we have to convert it into hn equals to 1 2 1 0. You getting my point? Now how to do the thing? So xn equals to 1 2 3 4. So this is done basically by matrix multiplication method. So 1 2 3 4. Now this 4 would come above 4 1 2 3. Now 3 would come on the top, 3 4 1 2. Then 2 would come on the top, 2 3 4 1. Now you have to keep in mind that whatever is your this first point, it appears in the diagonal in the matrix. Okay, you have to keep this in mind. If it does not appears, that means you have done something wrong somewhere, right? Now our signal would be 1 2 1 0. Okay. Now this is your RC equals to, of this matrix is equal to 4 by 4 and RC of this one is 4 by 1. So we'll be having an output which is having dimension of 4 by 1. Okay. So we get 1 plus 8 plus 3, 2 multiplied by 0 0. Okay, second is 2 plus 2 plus 4, right? Then third is 3 plus 4 plus 1. Then next one is 4 plus 6 प्लस टू, सो दिस इज 8 3 11, 12, 4 प्लस 4 8, 4 प्लस 4 8, 10 12. Okay, so this is another type of convolution. Herein, whatever is your input, whatever is your input length, that same will be the output length. Okay, but for the calculation of the output of the LTI systems, we need the output as the linear convolution. Okay, so whatever the result we should be getting, it should be in the linear convolution form. So this is the problem with the circular convolution. However, there is a trick to get around this problem. Now, what is the trick? So the trick is regarded as linear convolution by circular convolution. The method is regarded as linear convolution by circular convolution. Okay, so what to do that? We know that we are having a signal 1 2 3 4, so our XL is 1 2 3 4, L of X is equal to 4, L of H equal to 3, so L of Y would be how much?
6.
L of Y would be how much?
6.
6. Right. 4 plus 3 minus 1. Okay. Now our L of Y would be 6. And we know that in the circulation convolution, whatever is the input length is there, we have to we get an output which is of the same length. So that means we have to change the signal Xn such that it has a length of 6. Similarly, H of n should also have a length of 6. So again, how to do that? By zero padding, right? So let's see how we can perform that. The first one is 1 2 3 4 0 0. Okay, now it will be 0, sorry, Now, what is the h of n? 1, 2, 1, 0, 0, 0. So, what should be our output? 1, 0, this would be 0, this would be 0, 0, 0. So, first one is 1. Then 2 plus 1, no, sorry, 2 plus 2, then 0, 0, then 0, 0. Okay? Then 3 plus 4 plus 1. Then all these three are 0. Then we are having 4 plus 6 4 plus 6 plus 2. Then we are having 0 plus 8 put and this again 11 plus 3 3 plus 1 3 multiplied by 1 and then lastly we have 4. So we get 1, 4, 7, 8, 10, 12, 11, 4. Okay. So over here we get yn equals to 1, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Okay. I have not written the output over here. So let me write the output in this case. Yn equals to 12, 8. Okay, so you can see by implementing circular convolution, we can also implement the linear convolution. However, there is a trick. So while performing the circular convolution, linear convolution by the circular convolution method, we have to first calculate the length of the signal, okay, the length of the output signal, and based on that we have to create the matrices. Okay, right? So, do you need anything else?
No, sir.
Now, after understanding this, let's go to the numerical part, the equation part. How this convolution is being carried out? So we have the signals x of n 1, 2, 3, 4. To make the system bit harder, I'm not taking the origin as the first point, I'm taking the origin as the second point. Okay? Then we have h of n, which is given by 1, 2, 1. Right? Now, how to find this? We have to find or you can say the equation for the convolution of xn and hn, it is usually given by y of n equals to summation of m equals to minus infinity to infinity x of m h of n minus m. Okay, just make it more clearer. Right? So this is the equation what we get. Minus infinity to infinity. Now you can see there are lots of terms. There is an m term and all this thing. So how to get this? How to get the limits of the m? How to get the limits of the n? Because if you see, our signal is limited. It is not infinite. It is having components varying from minus n equals to minus 1 to n equals to 2, and here our n starts from 0 and it continues up to n equals to 2. So due to this reason, we have to find out the limits of the m and n. So what are the limits? How do you find out? So let's say the lower limit of L it is given by x of L and what is the lower limit? This one is the lower limit. So what is the value of n over here? The value of n is minus of 1. So ML is equal to minus 1. Okay. Similarly, m of h is equal to x of h, which is equal to 2. So we are basically talking about n equals to minus 1, 0, 1, 2. We are not interested in the values of xn. Are you getting my point? ML is, we are talking about in the time domain. What are these? X of n? X of n means it is time. H of n minus n, it is also a time. So we are, while calculating the limits of m and n, we are only interested in the time index values. So m of l is equal to minus of 1. See, it is minus of 1. It is the lower one. And m of h, it is equal to 2. Okay. Similarly, we have to calculate NL which is equal to XL plus HL. And NH equals to X of H plus H of H. Okay. Here what we get? XL means X lower. X lower is minus 1. And HL, in HL we are having 0, 1, 2, right? So XL is minus 1, HL is lower is 0. Plus 0 equals to minus 1. And for NH, X of H is high. It is 2 plus H of H is 2. This is 4. Right, now we have got the limits. Now we have to calculate this equation. So our NL is minus of 1. So on, in other words, we can just write down this equation as, rewrite this equation as YN equals to M equals to minus of 1 to 2, okay, X of M, H of N minus M, okay. So we have to find out yn from y of minus 1. It is equal to summation of m equals to minus 1 to 2 x of m h of minus 1 minus m. Okay, so this comes out to be m x of minus 1 into h of minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 plus x0 multiplied by h of minus 1 plus x1 multiplied by h of 0 plus x2 multiplied by h of 1. So x of minus 1 is 1 multiplied by 0 plus x of 0 is 2 multiplied by h of minus 1, it is again 0 plus x of 1 is 3 multiplied by 0, 1 plus x of 2 x of 2 is 4, sorry.
Sir, first one is h of minus 1 into h of 0.
Oh, m equals to minus 1, huh? Or minus 1 plus 1, huh? This would be 0. Okay. So minus 1, it is 0. Then 0. This is minus 1. X1. Oh, this is minus 2. One minus two, and then x two,
it's a minus three.
Minus three. Sorry. Yeah. So it comes out to be x of minus 1 is 1 multiplied by h of 0 is 1 plus x of 0 is 2 multiplied by h of minus 1, it is 0 plus x1 is 3 multiplied by h of minus 2, it is 0 plus x2, x2 is 4 multiplied by 0. So this comes out to be 1. Similarly, y0 we will be having summation of m equals to minus 1 to 2 x of m h of
minus m.
Right? So x of minus 1 multiplied by h of 1 plus x of 0 into h of 0 plus x of 1 multiplied by x of minus 1 plus x of 2 into h of minus 2. So x of minus 1 is 1 multiplied by h1 is 1, h of 1, sorry, 2 plus x of 0 is 2 multiplied by h of 0 is 2, h of 0 is 1. Plus x of 1 is 3 multiplied by, this is 8, sorry, plus h of minus 1 is 0. Plus x of 2 is 3 multiplied by 0. So this is 4. Now if you see what we have done, initially we were having, in this case, 1 multiplied by 1, then all were 0. So it was moved on the negative side. In the second case, see, 1 multiplied by 1, then this 2, it is getting multiplied by this one, x of minus 1 is 1 and h of 1 is 2. That means it was here. So this 2 is getting multiplied by this one, right? And then this 2, this is getting multiplied by this one. So it is basically just the sliding tape method. So we can find out accordingly y of 1, y of 2, y of 3 and y of 4, just from our previous things. So 1, 4, 8, 11, 8, 12, 11, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Okay. So we can calculate in this manner. So it is basically, if you see what I was trying to say, let me use another color pen. So 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the origin, and if you see the minus of 1, minus of 1 was here. So 1, 2, 1. So if you see 1 multiplied by 1, then 2 multiplied by 0, 2 multiplied by 0, 3 multiplied by 0, 4 multiplied by 0. So we got 1. If you look over here, what it would have done, this would have moved over here. So in the second case, we would have had 1, 2, 1. So what we are having, see, 1 multiplied by 2, okay, 2 multiplied by 1, right, then 3 multiplied by 0, and then this would be 4, I suppose, x of 2, yeah, x of 2, this would be 4. So see, 4 multiplied by 0, 0. In the next step, what would happen if I move this one? 1, 2, 1. So 1 multiplied by 1, 1, plus 2 multiplied by 2, 4, plus 3. So we would get 8. Then again, we will move on the right hand side, and then we will get 12, 11 and 4. Okay. So what is our final output? So our final output is, again, if you see, y of minus 1 is 1, 4, 8, 12, 11, 4. Okay. So this would be our final answer. There is just a mistake. I will tell you what is the mistake. The mistake is that I did not put the pivot, because of this my answer would have been incorrect. Okay, so when the origin is not the first element, you have to put up the pivot. Okay, so with this we conclude our class. So do you have any questions? Do you guys have
no,
any questions?
No, sir.